I started there a long time ago. Even when I was young, I was a UPC youth winger. I didn't know what we were doing. We were just busy insulting DP and shouting and sloganeering. As early as the age of 11, 12, as a very young man, and I used to call the late, my late cousin, Amos, they were UPC youth wingers, and I used to follow them. That's how I ended up a UPC youth winger myself. Then I participated in politics at various stages since then, up to now. Well, after 1996, you see, we conduct elections in this country. And like the rest of Africa, our election process is a bit inadequate in that the voters don't vote for value. They don't vote issues. They vote cousins, they vote money, they vote religion, they vote all sorts of variables which have nothing to do with politics. Then you end up with, sometimes you end up with people who are equal to the job, MPs. Sometimes you end up with councillors in parliament. People who should have remained at LC3 council end up in parliament. Just because people have voted a tribe's person, they have voted their religion, they voted somebody who bought them soap. Now that's the problem and the fallacy of the African elections. It's very unfortunate, but I believe with time and universal education, we shall get there, we shall achieve the ideal. No, Mbabazi would disagree. And I would be surprised if we agreed all the time. When two people are working together, and if when they don't disagree, it means one of them is thinking. When two people are working together on the same program and disagree, that's healthy. When they don't disagree, then there is something wrong. Disagreement is not the problem. It's the inability to overcome the contradiction that is the problem. I have no problem with Mbabazi as a friend, you know, but I sometimes disagree with his methods. Sometimes I disagree with his strategy, you know. Sometimes we don't agree, but we are not enemies. We disagree, you know, and I proved him wrong. Say the way you are running the NRM is not exactly the way it should be done, you know. And now you can see subsequently what is happening. You know, like the Buganda abandoning the NRM started 15 years ago because you could see it was coming. That the way we are handling the central region and other areas, we are going to end up in this problem. You know, in Uganda, there are errors we made which have resulted in what has happened. And I used to warn Mbabazi about this possibility. You know, but now that him and I have seen it and have been proved correct, now we can work together. We can now sit on the same table and say, didn't I tell you? Now let's see where we went wrong and see how we can go on. I have no problems with Mbabazi as a person. We've grown up together for a very long time. I've known him for more than 50 years. Yeah, I've not talked to him. I don't know whether he's back. I know there has been a rapprochement between him and the party chairman. Now, I don't know to what extent. I've not had occasion to talk to Mbabazi and see what his take in this is. You know, he may say, okay, I'm willing to help. And I think he should come back and correct the mistakes he made, correct his errors. He should come and do what he did, you know, the mistakes he made. Because I could see there were a few errors we were making. Now, and in a struggle, we welcome all hands on deck. If Mbaba says no, I think the path I took was not correct, and he says I can come back and make a contribution, he's welcome. There's nobody who should stop Mbabazi from coming back to make a contribution. Uganda does not belong to anybody. The NRM does not belong to anybody. The NRM is supposed to outlive us. So if we can, you know, if we can come back and help to reshape the NRM and reshape the country, he's welcome. There's no problem. No, there are quite a number of things that I think, that I personally think went where we went wrong. But I don't want to discuss it now until I've been able to face my colleagues in the NRM with these facts. I don't want to put it in public as yet because it may damage our subsequent strategy in bringing Buganda back to the NRM fold. Buganda will come back, definitely. Once we change strategy, Buganda will come back. You know, it's painful that Buganda, that at this epoch, Buganda, which used to have over one third of members in the NRM caucus, now instead of 100, they have less than 30. And it's the NRM caucus that determines the direction of the country. Now you can see that we are going to have an NRM caucuses where Uganda will be underrepresented. No, it will be represented, but the representation will be under strength. Uganda will not have the same voice like it used to have in the previous administrations. And that's not desirable. Uganda should have its 100 members of caucus. But now they are going to have about 29, I don't know, 29, 30, you know. And I don't know, those 29, 30 are going to discuss issues of their local areas because the people of Kochi cannot represent Buganda. The people of Nakasongola have their own chief. They can't represent Buganda. The people of Kayunga, they have their own chief. They are not representative of the sentiments and aspirations of Buganda Kingdom. Kochi, they have their own chief. Nakasongola, they have their own chief. The Naka Kayunga have their own chief. And unfortunately for Buganda, these are the people who have come on the NRM ticket. So nobody is going to talk about the core values of Buganda. Much as, yes, for us, me, I don't care whether there is Uganda or Angola, I'm a Ugandan. First of all, I'm an African. So as an African, what hurts Uganda hurts me. So I'm not particular about Uganda. But you see, there are some of these sentimental issues of Buganda. Partial and, you know, sentiments. So, not really important things, not important issues. Because in terms of economic development, the central region will enjoy the same treatment like everybody else. Education, health, what services, they will enjoy like everybody else. But then there are sentimental issues that the people of Buganda would want to talk about, would want to express. We may agree with what they are saying or disagree with what they are saying, but at least they should have opportunity to voice out their feelings. Like, I don't agree with them on the question of federal, but they should be able to sit on the table and talk about it. Convince me, persuade me about federal, and I persuade them to abandon federal. It's that interaction, that health interaction, that is going to miss within the NRM caucus. I want to listen to Buganda, even when they are wrong, even when they are saying things which are wrong, obviously wrong, but I want to listen. I want them to have opportunity to voice those wrong opinions of theirs at the table where we're having discussion. And this is unfortunate, what they are going to miss. Why should I go for federal? I'm looking for African unity now. You're talking about Buganda. I'm an African. Are Buganda Europeans? Are they from Europe or from heaven? The Africans, you don't know. When I'm talking about Otafiire, I'm talking about Otafiire. Do you say, now, what about your feet? No, the feet are part of me. The feet are part of me. So me, when I speak for Africa and African people, Buganda is also included. But there are those who don't want to look at Africa in a whole, and they want to talk about Buganda. They forget that we are Africans, we are East Africans, and we are Ugandans. They start with Buganda. But it is their democratic and God-given right to talk about themselves. That's what I want to hear. And there is no way I can persuade them to abandon that course unless I listen to what they are saying. And then they listen to what I'm saying. You know, I want that opportunity to talk to them and say, these views of yours, wonderful as they are wrong. Yeah. Like people say, used to believe that rain is caused by witchcraft. once you convince them that it's precipitation, then they will abandon those views. But before you convince them that rain is a result of evaporation and condensation, they will still believe that rain is caused by witchcraft. And they are convinced, and they are willing to go to die for that belief, wrong as it is. Wrong as it is. Now I want Buganda, call Buganda, at the table of discussion, so that we can listen to each other. And when you listen to each other, that's a panacea for not making trouble. When people have been heard, then it is foolish of them, and it's rare that they will start trouble. That they will get disgruntled.